This is gonna be the best day of my life. This is gonna be the best day of my life. My life.
Tried to cut these corners, try to take the easy way out. I kept on falling short of something. I could have gave up then, but then again I couldn't have, cause I've traveled all this way for something. I take it in, but don't look down.
Cause I'm on top of the world.
Tonight is my appraisal, cause I'm a hooker selling songs and my pimp's a record label. This world is full of demon stocks and bonds and Bible traders. So I do the deed, get up and leave, a climber and a sadist, yeah.
Are you ready for the sequel? Ain't you ready for the latest? In the garden of evil, I'm gonna be the greatest. In a golden cathedral, I'll be praying for the faithless. Boo-hoo. Hey, look, Ma, I made it. Hey, look, Ma, I made it. Everything's coming up aces, aces. If it's a dream, don't wake it, don't wake it. I said, hey, look, Ma, I made it.
Good evening, and welcome to the December 2020 Associate Degree Nursing Program Opening Ceremony. It is my honor on behalf of the Board of Trustees of North Idaho College and our President, Dr. Rick McLennan, to welcome you to this pinning ceremony. I would also like to just take a little bit of time to recognize others who support our nursing program so well throughout the years and over and have supported them over the years. Starting with our Board of Trustees, I'd like to mention Mr. Todd Benducci, who is currently serving as the chair of our Board of Trustees, Mr. Greg McKenzie, who is the vice chair, Ken Howard, Christy Wood, and Michael Barnes. Thank you all for all you do to support North Idaho College. I also want to acknowledge our fearless leader, Dr. Rick McLennan, president of North Idaho College, and my colleagues, the vice presidents, Dr. Graydon Stanley, vice president for student services, Chris Martin, Vice President for Finance and Business, and other members of the President's Cabinet, including Rayelle Anderson, Director of Development at NIC, Karen Hubbard, Chief Human Resources Officer, Laura Rumpler, Chief Communications and Governmental Relations Officer, Ken Wardinsky, Chief Information Officer. And the people who support me most to do my job as the Vice President for Instruction, it would be the three deans at North Idaho College: Christy Doyle, Dean of Health Professions; Larry Briggs, Dean of General Education; and Lloyd Newman, Dean of Instructional Support. I'm going to take just a little bit of time to offer some introductory remarks, but I'm not going to take a lot of time because this ceremony really is all about our graduates and what we are going to see in a few minutes in terms of them being pinned. Nursing pinning ceremonies are really near and dear to my heart. I was thinking about how many nursing pinning ceremonies I've attended over the years, and I'm thinking I'm pushing numbers like 70. And that's because I've been in higher education and nursing education for about 30 years, and I had my own nursing parent pinning ceremony. And I will tell you that nursing pinning ceremonies are one of the most meaningful ceremonies that we do at colleges and to honor our graduates. It really is recognizing that transition from a student to a professional. And I'm just so honored to be here doing this. Now, let me fully admit that this is by far the oddest experience I've ever had in terms of being present at a nursing ceremony. I'm in a room with four or five other people, socially distanced, just took off my mask. I can't see any of the graduates, and that really breaks my heart, because that is what gives me such joy, is being able to see those graduates walk across the stage. I so long for things being the same. You know, this last 10 months for us, there has been nothing that has felt the same to us. And I really, truly long for that. On the other hand, we do have some positive things we can think about as it relates to our COVID experience. And in some ways, this virtual experience could be viewed as being very positive. For one thing, I've been noticing the chats go up on the screen ahead of the ceremony. And it's so wonderful to see families, friends, husbands, wives, children be able to give their graduates that very personal shout out on the chat message. So although that's not the same, that's almost better than what the same was. But I do want to talk about maybe what is the same. And what is the same about this nursing parent pinning ceremony is that regardless of what is going on in our world and in our own environment here in Kootenai County and on our own campus, we respect and honor what is happening this afternoon as these nurses get pinned. We respect and honor that so much that we would really go to almost any measure to ensure that they are receiving their due honor in recognition of their accomplishments to get to this point and be the professional nurses that they will be in just a few weeks when they take their NCLEX exams. You know, I think there's been so many lessons taken from the experience that we had the last 10 months. And one of the things that I have noted, we always knew that our students were very persistent in achieving their goals. But the other thing that we've noticed in this last couple of semesters is the resiliency of students. You know, for these graduates, there wasn't going to be hell or high water or COVID that was going to prevent them from getting to this completion mark. And to all of you, I just offer my sincere congratulations and commendations for being resilient, for doing what it took, whatever it took, to get to this point. The other thing I think that came out of the last several months is a renewed desire to bring compassion and caring back into nursing. It's always been there. Sometimes it gets hidden, sometimes it gets faded. Sometimes we get so caught up with the technology and the skills and the tasks and everything that we have to do as nurses. And I'm saying we, like I practiced recently. I haven't. It's been a really long time, but my memory's good in that aspect. So trust that I know how we get caught up in those sort of things. And sometimes the compassion has been second fiddle to the important other things that we are doing and caring for patients. But as I've been watching different news releases, different feature stories on frontline workers, and many, many times on nurses. What I have seen is the compassion that comes when a nurse is now the only person who might be beside a patient as they are suffering and perhaps dying from this COVID. And I think that that representation, public representation, truly portrays what the nurse does. The nurse not only brings all of her knowledge, skills, and abilities to that bedside, but she brings also her compassion and caring so that, that those patients get holistic care. And so that's just a bit of, not even advice, but the bit of thanks that I'm going to give to these graduates, because I really believe that these graduates also possess that compassion, and they are going to go out and demonstrate that to everyone they give care to. So to all of you, congratulations. We are so proud of you. We look forward to hearing about all the wonderful things you do in your career. Thank you. Oh, I'm now to introduce Erlene, who is the director of our nursing program.
Thank you, Dr. Burns. We appreciate your ongoing support of the nursing program. My name is Erlene Pickett, and I'm the director of the nursing programs here at NIC. On behalf of the nursing faculty, I'd like to welcome you to the December 2020 pinning ceremony. Graduates, what a journey you've been on these last 2 years. I suspect there was lots of excitement and maybe a little bit of fear when you received a letter saying you had been accepted and you attended that first orientation session where you were told life as you knew it was going to change, so buckle up. You're right, it's been a little bit bumpier than most thanks to the hurdles experienced due to COVID-19. But you managed to stay on course, and here you are at the final juncture of attaining your associate degree in nursing. Well, we've gone through a few different plans as to how to hold this pinning ceremony. We finally found one that worked. And please believe me when I say we are excited to be able to applaud all of your accomplishments as you complete the associate degree nursing program here at North Idaho College. There are many people who have helped you through the process. So while we can't offer applause in the normal way, we want to offer thanks to all of your families, friends, classmates, NIC staff and faculty who contributed to making it possible for you to reach this moment. I'd like to take a moment to mention those who have been part of the student's journey over the last 2 years. Candy Zimmerman, Senior Administrative Assistant for the Nursing Division. Tara Garber, Part-Time Administrative Assistant for the Nursing Division. Wendy McIntosh, Nursing Advisor. Jeff Davis, Pre-Nursing Advisor. Miles Larson, Simulation Operations Specialist. Stephanie Bradbury, Clinical Coordinator. And Linda Holloway, the Senior Assistant Administrative Assistant for the Health Professions Program. Our faculty are dispersed with the students in rooms across campus, so we can meet the requirements for social gathering together. However, I do want to mention their names. Blythe Buchan coordinates pinning, and she teaches in the first and the fourth semester. Rachel Kalk teaches in the second and third semester. Jane Edwards teaches in the first semester. Sharon Funkhauser teaches in the fourth semester. Sheila Hurst teaches in the second and third semester. Trisha Robinson teaches in the third semester. Amy Shinost, who teaches in the first and the second semester. Stephen Smith, who teaches in the third semester. Anoy Williamson, who teaches in the second semester. And we also are joined by Brittany Heidenreich and Jean Marifice, who teach in the PN program. And of course, Barb Downey, who is our beloved Learning Lab coordinator. Some of you may be wondering what the significance of the pinning ceremony is. It's a time-honored tradition that dates back to the 1860s when Florence Nightingale presented a Medal of Excellence to her hardest working nursing graduate. By 1960, it became standard in the U.S. to award all graduates with a pin during a special ceremony. The pin symbolizes the nurse's dedication to his or her patients. Each nursing school has a pin that visually represents their school. Our NIC pin is located on the front of the program for you to be able to see. The Florence Nightingale lamp, which she carried with her when tending the wounded during the Crimean War, represents comfort, goodwill, warmth, and steadfast devotion to duty in the dark nights of the hospitals. Now we use pen lights and flashlights. The hands represent the specialized skills that you have learned and will practice throughout your nursing career. The books, which probably should now be an electronic device such as a laptop or cell phone, represent the scientific knowledge that you've gained in nursing school as lifelong learners. You will continue to build on this knowledge base throughout your career. With this pin also comes a commitment and responsibility to practice the skill and art of nursing to the best of your ability. So tonight it is our opportunity to welcome you to the profession of nursing. We are honored to have been a part of your journey and proud to have you join us in this profession. So with that, I want to say congratulations. Students have selected Jane Edwards to address the class. Jane has been a nurse for 28 years. She began her nursing career as an LPN and has worked her way through the educational pathway to a master's degree in nursing. She provided direct patient care in a variety of settings for the first 13 years of her career and has spent the last 15 years as a nurse educator. Jane is passionate about ensuring students know the art of bedside nursing. Jane will be retiring at the end of this semester, and she will be missed. I'd like to invite Jane to the podium.
Thank you all for coming. This is a wonderful night. I don't know if you remember, but at orientation, when you began nursing school, I said it will go so fast. Wasn't I right? Didn't it go fast? Well, you've been looking forward to this night for at least 2 years, if not longer. So I have a few words to say to you tonight. First, to the families of the graduates, and then to the graduates themselves. The families of the graduates. I am sure that many of you are as happy as the graduates themselves are, for you've sacrificed to help your loved one get to this night. I have some advice to you who are about to be connected to in some way to a nurse. Number one, living with a nurse may take some getting used to. First and foremost, they're going to start making a decent paycheck. And I can just hear yells in the background, even though I can't. But there may be a price to pay for that paycheck. I want the families of the nurses to understand the toll nursing may temporarily take on their loved one. An average nurse spends his or her day using all of their physical and mental energy and their emotional strength caring for someone else's needs. They often neglect their own needs as they're caring for other people's needs. Add to this the stress of making life and death decisions, and it compounds their fatigue. My point is that after a 12-hour shift, your nurse is going to need some time to regroup and recharge. Don't worry. With some rest, they'll come around and be their old self again. But after two or three 12-hour shifts in a row, it may take some more time, so just give them the space that they need. Number two, get used to talking about body fluids, such as when your nurse comes home and talks about blood, pus, wound drainage, urine, vomit, or BMs, please don't take offense. They are not trying to gross you out. They're just sharing their day. Finally, if you see your nurse looking at you and their eyes get big and wide and they get a big smile on their face, don't conclude a romantic interlude is about to happen. They just see your big poppy veins and would love to start an IV on you. Finally, for the nurses, the graduates, just think you're never going to have to hear drop the program again or upward and onward like you did on a regular basis from me. I realize that I've said just about everything useful I could say to you during the last couple of years. But just as my mom used to call to me before I left the house, Jane Elizabeth, just one more thing before you go. And I would roll my eyes as I listened. I too have a few more things to say to you. But because I do believe it takes an entire nursing faculty to grow a nurse, I have asked the nursing faculty to give you their parting advice. The following are the pieces of advice your nursing faculty are giving you. This is from Anoy Williamson. Give yourself some credit and be patient with yourself. You've got this. You were smart enough to pass the NCLEX and obtain your license, but now you just need to put everything you've learned into practice. Take a deep breath and get on in there. It can take a while to feel comfortable, and remember that there is no stupid question. As nurses, we never stop learning, and that is so true. And this only makes your practice stronger. The next one is from our fearless leader, Erlene Pickett. And she said, I hope graduates will always be compassionate towards patients and families they care for. May they maintain patient-centered care and remember that everyone has a story that may not be immediately evident. They are in a position to have great impact in a positive or negative manner. So use your time with those you're caring for wisely. I would also mention that Erlene said this to me and I wanted to bring it up. Remember how you were treated as a student by the nurses. You're going to have students now. And yes, it can be time consuming to have a student. It can be more difficult. But remember to welcome them in as you've been welcomed from the good nurses that welcomed you in. Sheila Hurst's advice is find a mentor. That's short and sweet. Welcome to nursing and thank you for choosing such a profession. As you now know, there's you. Thank yous in nursing come in different varieties and ways with such power and truth. The sweet thank you from the gentlewoman for helping her eat her applesauce and pudding as she told stories of her youth. The thank you that came in celebration with the loved ones of the patient's life that you helped to save. Or the quiet thank you that came with a different story. The not happy ending because they held on to you and cried next to you, talked with you because you had the honor in caring for their loved one in such a vulnerable time. Your caring heart and sacrifices don't go unnoticed. Welcome to the world of nursing. Those thank yous are my favorite part of nursing. Remember to relish these. To relish in these valuable moments of the silent or quick thank yous. They will get you through the days you wonder what in the heck you were doing. These are the moments you answer your why did I become a nurse? These are the best moments, all of them. And by the way, this was all submitted by Tricia Robinson. The next is Stephen Smith. His silly advice, if it's wet and it's not yours, put gloves on. I would say that's true. I use this one in my end of life lecture, paraphrasing a Patch Adams quote. If we treat our patient as a disease, we will win some and lose some. But if we treat our patient as a person, then we win every time, regardless of the outcome. The only thing I would add to this, if we treat each patient as though they were a beloved family member, especially those hard to love, then everything else will fall correctly into place. And Amy Scheinost, questions are always worth asking. Encourage others to ask questions by asking questions yourself. This is by Blythe Buchan. Remember that self-care is very important. You cannot pour from an empty cup, and it's okay to say no in order to care for yourself. I just want to interject on Blythe. This is a great one. You're going to be asked to work extra shifts. Think about your family before you say yes. I'm not saying you should never work an extra shift, but I've seen what it does to nurses if they work too many extra shifts. And I cannot help but think and question whether it's worth the money. Connie Sue Klum, cheat. Okay, this isn't really cheating, but you no longer have to memorize everything for an exam. Carry a pocket reference guide. Use your small notebook to write down things like drip rates, normal lab values, drug calculations, anything you need to know that's specific to your specialty. Download some apps. Your goal is patient care and safety, not passing the test. That is, until you pass the NCLEX. Rachel Kalk, my advice would be to be flexible and willing to learn new things, and at the end of each day, feel comfortable that you've done the best you could for your patients. Sharon Funkhauser, remember, this is your lifelong career. You have years of work ahead of you. Be sure to find your work-life balance and find ways to separate your nurse role from your whole life. You will find joy in your career longer if you don't allow the stress of being a new nurse to take over. Take care of your health and your body. And now my piece of advice. It's as the popular song said, to give faith a fighting chance. I don't believe I ever worked a shift as a nurse when I didn't first pray, Lord, help me to see the things I need to see, and may I cause no harm to any patient. That was the heart's desire I had. It was my heartfelt prayer. And you know, God heard me. I can't tell you the number of times I was concerned about a patient prayed for them. The vast majority never knew I was praying for them. The patient who had just gotten a bleak prognosis. The patient with pain that could not be alleviated by medication. And yes, just as I taught you, I took them to the bathroom. I repositioned them. I got a warm blanket for them. Sometimes I get a milkshake for them. But nothing I did seemed to help. And I'd always turn to prayer to help them. Also, the patient that was on the call like more than a human being should be allowed to be. These are all patients I prayed for. I prayed continually for them and for me that I could be the nurse that they needed me to be. I remember one particular patient. I'd taken care of him for 2 days, and this was my third day. And he again was my patient. On the first 2 days, he seemed extremely sad and never had a visitor at all. He answered most of my questions with short responses, even my open-ended questions. This was a teaching hospital, so there were always interns and residents on the floor. One morning, right after report, I heard an intern call out, "Who's got 250? And I said, "I do." I had just received report, and that day I had not seen him yet. The intern said, "Get him on a gurney and get him to OR now." The CNA and I got the patient on the gurney, and I was pushing him down the hall to the OR as fast as I could. And right before we got to the OR, the patient looked up at me and said with a desperate look on his face, "Jane, help me." I blurted out the truth because I didn't have time to think and to make sure my speech was politically correct. And you guys know, my speech is rarely politically correct. I said, John, I'll pray for you. And the patient said to me, "Oh, Jane, that won't help. God doesn't like me." And off he went through the doors, and I was quickly giving the nurse report. We often don't know the outcomes of the patients we care for, and that was the case with this patient. But I went home the next day. I went home that day, and then I had the next 4 days off, and I was back at work a week later. And as I was walking to the med room, I heard someone shout, "Jane!" And I turned and looked into the room where I saw the patient that I rushed to the OR. He had the biggest grin on his face, and he said excitedly, "Jane, God heard your prayer." It was the first time I'd seen him smile. I said, "Of course he did." He rested back against the pillow and seemed quite content. I want to say to you, don't think God won't hear your prayer. He will. You know, I've not only prayed for my patients, I've prayed for some of you too. You who needed to get a certain score to pass to the next level. When we're sitting up there up behind the desk, what do you think we're doing? And you're taking the test. Do you think that we're doing crossword puzzles or checking our phones? Maybe occasionally. But some of us are praying like mad for you guys. You being here and graduating are proof that God hears prayers. Again, don't think that God won't hear you. He will. Finally, I want to close with some of the words of my favorite nursing theorist, Virginia Henderson. The National Library of Nursing is named for Virginia Henderson. And when I took my master's, we had to pick a theorist and apply it to so many different things. And a lot of the nursing theorists, I don't even know what planet they were on. But Virginia Henderson was a bedside nurse, and she was very practical. But I want to share something that she wrote that I think is quite beautiful. Be the consciousness of the unconscious, the love of life for the suicidal. Be the leg of the amputee, the eyes of the newly blind, the means of locomotion for an infant, and the confidence for the new mother. You are now their advocates. And tonight, I am no longer your nursing instructor. I'm your peer. Welcome to nursing.
Thank you, Jean. We will now move to the first group of students and faculty for presentation of the pins and recognition of students for being inducted into the Nursing Honor Society. We'll move to Molstead 101 first.
The OADN Honor Society purpose is to promote scholarships and academic excellence in the profession of nursing. This society encourages the pursuit of advanced degrees in the profession of nursing, as well as continuing education as a lifelong professional responsibility. Membership into the society is optional and by invitation only. To be eligible, students must have a cumulative GPA of 3.0 or above in nursing program courses, as well as the required prerequisites. This is no small feat. There are students that have been unable to complete this program academically. However, the Honor Society students you see have not only completed this rigorous nursing program, they have maintained at least a B average, and in many cases, higher than that. They have also demonstrated conduct on the college campus and in the clinical setting that reflects the integrity and professionalism. They realize that success is no accident. It is hard work, perseverance, learning, studying, sacrificing, and most of all, love of what you are learning to do. These students have looked at how long it would take to accomplish their goals and have taken it step by step and know that one day it will all be worth it. In addition to the academic and professionalism requirements, each student participated in one educational or recruitment project during their time of provisional membership. The students who are inducted into this year's OADN Honor Society are Abigail Aker, Sonia Appolt, Kayla Bush, Sydney Bybee, Teddy Call, Sydney Cobb, Jennifer Connor, Hannah Davis, Chelsea Gritness, Lori Putzig, Riley Ryben, Eilish Smith, and Brianne Zhao. Congratulations to the newly inducted members of Alpha Delta Nu Epsilon Gamma. You have exceeded the rigorous standards of this ADN program and have demonstrated the ideal qualifications of a scholar and nursing leader. Ladies and gentlemen, may I present to you the future leaders in nursing. We will now begin with the presentation of class pins.
Abigail Aker. Kayla Allred. Sonia Appolt. Joel Fuller. Kayla Bush. Sydney Bybee. Teddy Call. Woo-hoo! Brittany Catron. Nicole Chapman. Sydney Cobb. Andrea Collins. And Jennifer Connor.
Chelsea Brittman.
Letterman.
Welcome to room 5.
Oh, there we are.
Hannah Davis.
Go in.
Lauren Hansen. Lori Putzing. Riley Reben.
Is that right?
Eilish Smith.
You did it!
Kylie Stark. And Bree Zale.
Thank you.
Achievement Award is presented to the student who has the highest cumulative grade point average in the graduating class. The grade point average is based upon all of the courses needed for the ADN degree, which includes the core nursing classes. This recipient is recognized at Penny, and their name is engraved on a large plaque, which is permanently displayed in the Health and Science Building. The student who will receive the award tonight has an outstanding grade point average. The student with the highest GPA for the graduating class of December 2020 is Lauren Hanson.
Each semester, a member of the graduating class is selected for the honor of the Spirit of Nursing Award. This recipient is recognized at Penny, and his or her name is engraved on a large plaque, which is permanently displayed in the Health and Science Building. The nominees were selected by the graduating class and by the NIC faculty for excellence in the aspects of respect, integrity, professionalism, caring, compassion, and cultural competence, which was evident in all personal and professional behaviors and interactions. The nominees showed dedication, excellence, and a passion for the profession of nursing. Let me paraphrase some of the comments given by the students and faculty about selected nominees. This candidate is extremely considerate, compassionate, and passionate about patient care. She seems to get along with everyone in class, participates and contributes to class discussions, and is responsive and quick to get back to instructors in a timely manner. Despite the masks required this semester, it was still clear that this person had a ready smile on her face. It is my honor and pleasure to introduce the Fall 2020 Spirit of Nursing Award to Hannah Davis.
Each semester, a member of the graduating class is selected for the honor of the Leadership Award. The recipient of this award is recognized at Penning, and their name is engraved on a large plaque, which is permanently displayed in the Health and Science Building. The nominated students have exemplified outstanding service and leadership to their fellow students and to the community. They have shown a commitment to excellence and a willingness to inspire others. With much thought and consideration, one student was selected by the faculty. The student chosen for this semester has been a positive and encouraging example to fellow students and community members. This student has participated in class every semester, asking clarifying questions, contributing to classroom discussion, and engaging her peers in thoughtful discussions regarding course material. The student will undoubtedly continue to exemplify the leadership quality as he or she continues a career in nursing. I'm proud to present the Fall Leadership 2020 Award to Riley Reeven.
I'd now like to ask the class of December 2020 to please rise. We're going to recite the and invite you to recite the Florence Nightingale Pledge, and the faculty as well, of course. Go ahead and light your candle. And it's on the back of your program, or it's on the overhead. I pledge myself here before my God and in the presence of this assembly to practice my profession with integrity. I will endeavor to maintain and elevate the standard of nursing, both as a science and as an art. I wholeheartedly recognize the importance of high standards of care and of personal accountability. I devote myself to the healing, protection, and welfare of those committed to my care. I accept the duty to work for the improvement of health in the communities in which I live and work. I will hold in confidence all personal matters committed to my keeping and will respect the privacy of medical information. I will act with compassion in ethical matters. I will not knowingly administer or consume any harmful substance. I commit to interdisciplinary collaboration and lifelong learning. I fully acknowledge the seriousness of the responsibility that is accepted in my calling and the significance of this pledge that I take today. And I believe we'll ask you to stay standing or lean.
And a special thank you to North Idaho College IT department and the event team for helping us be able to offer this pinning ceremony. They've done incredible work to make this happen, and so we thank you immensely. This concludes the pinning ceremony for the December 2020 class. Thank you for joining us as we celebrate our graduates.
Closing time for you to go out to the places you will be from.